I'm Brigham Larson with Brigham Larson Pianos. We just finished this 1880 Fischer. The people that had us do this, they didn't want us to go do a full rebuild, and they also didn't want us to do the full refinishing. So this is a good opportunity to kind of showcase what we do, kind of at a lesser. Sometimes it's a budget constraint, and so there's plenty of pianos that we redo for that at a lower level for that reason. And in this case, I don't think it was quite as much a budget constraint as it was she just really likes sort of a rustic look. She wanted it to be a big improvement from what it was, but not like perfection. This is an 1880 originally, and this is rosewood, which rosewood is super cool. Rosewood was totally over-harvested in the 19th century for furniture, pianos included, and to the point where now it's super illegal, as is ivory. And this piano also has ivory, and she made the same request, this client, that we leave the ivory. And so a lot of times we'll replace on pianos that we restore, we'll replace the keytops with plastic. So it's perfect, you know, everything is white and straight and absolutely pristine. And she didn't want that. That wasn't in her plan. And by the way, we're back in the storage room. I apologize. We've got just pianos coming out of our ears everywhere. That's where this piano happens to be as I make this video. And so, yeah, let's check this out. Okay, so this is our lower level of refinishing. It still looks very, very good. You can still see a lot of kind of rustic features, which is what she wanted. This is kind of cool. The way that comes out when this is up. And this is kind of a cool little music thing. Pops in there. So, and then there's the ivory. You can see that it's very imperfect, but that's definitely a cool look. We did refinish or replate rather the hardware, the metal hardware, like the lock and the pedals and that little trim piece around the pedals. And here's another example of, let's see, on this side, it was just super gashed up, missing some veneer, and I think on the other side as well. And she wanted it better than it was, but not absolute, down at the bottom, not absolute perfection, which is, I think, what she got. So still, like I said, very much an 1880 look with some rusticness, but beautiful. But, you know, so a good mix of old and new. Okay, then, so much for the outside, the inside. Same kind of idea where the parts that were just absolutely trashed, we replaced. We essentially replaced everything that really absolutely needed to be replaced so that the piano is at least reasonably playable. So the strings, for example, the strings are original 1880. They have lost some tone, a lot of tone, in fact, in the bass, and you'll hear that in a minute, but they're still good. They still sound good. They still sound reasonably rich. The hammers were completely shot, as is usually the case with pianos from the 19th century. The dampers as well, so we replaced those. And then the bushings, bridle straps, lots of leather. You can see like the back on the back checks here. That leather has been replaced. These hammer butts are original, but they've been repinned. So everything, of course, pivots on just a metal pin that goes through there. And over time, there's wobble that develops, and so we take that out and repin it. These are called shanks. These are the basically the dowels. I'm going to turn that off. Sorry about that. We, like I said, we are in the storage room where we have our air compressors. And then other little kind of nice touches, like these are the original giant bolts there, but the but we've polished them up so they kind of look nice. And really nice job on these hammers, nice and straight and professional. Same with the rest of the action. It's just consistent and lots of like re-gluing and repairing and putting breaking the glue joint of the jacks and re-gluing that so it's nice and secure for another 100 years, replacing things like the let off felt, those kinds of things. And then down here, let's have a look down here where we've rebuilt the trap work so that it's just clean and fresh. So let's listen to it. Sounds great. I think for what this particular client wanted, I think we totally nailed it. It is just like combination best of the old, but brought back to work like new. And really, I'm really happy with it. We're actually delivering it tomorrow. I think she hasn't seen it yet. So but I'm confident she's going to be really happy with it as well. 1880 Fischer. Thanks for watching.